You're on Mars. It's not particularly welcoming, so you'll need the essentials. Food, water, air, shelter, and hopefully a powerful source of energy to help you survive your new home. I'm Wrenn Schmidt, and we're exploring the science behind For All Mankind. What would it take to survive on Mars, like our stranded For All Mankind crew? They could stretch what they brought with them, but to generate the supplies they'd need long-term, they'll need a lot of power. Fortunately, our crew could harness the limitless energy technology that helped define this season. Nuclear fusion. So, why is fusion more powerful than the atomic energy we already create? Fission, with an I, is nuclear power as we know it. It splits an atom which releases energy. But it also creates radioactive waste. Fusion, on the other hand, fuses two atoms. This releases a lot more energy. And if you use an element like helium-3, you'll create a lot less waste. So, where can we find helium-3? Solar winds have been blasting the moon for billions of years, depositing an estimated 1.1 million tons of helium-3 on the surface. We'd only need 25 tons to power the United States for an entire year. How can we get this powerful resource from the moon? Well, the way they mine helium-3 in the show is a blueprint for what we could do. Using a bucket wheel excavator, we could collect that helium-rich lunar regolith. Heat it to 700 degrees Celsius to release the helium-3, alongside oxygen and hydrogen, two other valuable resources in space, which we'd separate and store. Finally, we'd transport the helium-3 to Mars to use in a fusion reactor, giving us the power we'd need to generate the essentials for sustaining life. Nuclear fusion could power the future of life on Mars. Scientists are still trying to crack how to get more energy out of fusion reactions than they put in. But a future fueled by safe, abundant, clean energy, good for Mars, great for Earth, game-changing for all mankind.